Hey, hello everyone. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to find the length of the string in C++. So let's get started. So currently I have an empty program here. So first let me declare a string. So string str is going to be the name of a string. And let's input it from the user C in str. So actually there are two ways of finding the length of a string. One is by using a for loop and then is by using our functions. So first I will go with the for loop because in most of the cases, they will ask you in case of any programming round or programming test. They will ask you to find only by using the for loop because that's the difficult part. So just put a for loop, okay, for int I equal to 0. And here we are just going to iterate through the string and we will have a counter. For each iteration, we will increment the counter value by 1. And if the iteration reaches the end of the string, that is it points to null. The end of the string is always equal to null. So our counter will stop. So that's the basic condition. So our string is str. So str condition is going to be str of I not equal to null. Okay, so our loop terminates when it has reached the last character of a string, and the last character of a string is null. That's a simple condition we are having, and I plus plus usually. And if you just open it and count plus plus, okay, so we need to initialize count value as 0, count equal to 0, and see out our count. Okay, so that's it. Really good. So I will be 0, and as str of I not equal to 0, it will just go on, keep on iterating I value, and the only reaches last character, that is last character of str of I, will be equal to null, and our loop will terminate, and we will get the count as out. Pretty simple. Okay, so only condition is that last character of a string is null. That's it. So I will type something. Okay, I will rrrr 4 hours, so we'll get the output as 4. That's really good. And you can also represent this null as slash 0. So I will run and execute this also. RRR. So we're getting 3. So slash 0 is also null. So we can do both the ways, play around with that. And our next thing is going to be with our inbuilt functions. So first, I will go with the cout of str.length. So as you can see here, it gets automatically displayed length. And now if I just execute it, I will get that length directly. So 3, I'm getting 3. And another function is size. So as you can see here, there isn't any header file, specific header file required for this function. I'm just doing with this IO stream. So for size also, there is an inner file, we can get the thing. And the only problem with this is that you can't give sentences with the spaces, because as you can see here, if I put this, I'll be getting 3 as the output. So for that, what you need to do is, you can either initialize hard coded like this, you can give space and type something. So currently I have 7 characters, okay, if I just execute it, I'll get 7 as the output. You can hard code it. Oh, sorry, I need to take this string. And if I just execute it now, so we'll get 7 of the output. So to avoid this, you can just use a get line. Okay, so it's going to be get line name of scene, get line scene, comma, and the name of your variable. Okay, that's it. So by this way, you will be able to give a sentence or words with spaces. So if I just execute it and I'm putting rrr space ttt, I'll get 7 of the output. So these are the ways, many ways you can like count the length of a string. Okay, so I have showed you by using for loop, but a single word for loop, and I have used two functions, and I have also showed you by using words with spaces or sentences. So that's it for this video, and my name is a program channel. Do subscribe and check out my other videos of my channel. I've done tutorials in Python, C++, Java, Blender. So subscribe and support me, and thanks for watching.